I've been running your gear, in particular the Cobra 1.75, the Toxic Green Micro Rig, Toxic Green Bungee Sling, and I think that's it. The last 4 days in advance, mm-hmm. and we'll be doing it the next day and a half too, and for the foreseeable future, and it just works, man. Dude. I mean, I know you said this Cobra belt, the 1.75, is a little bit less stiff than the EDC.
It is.
But you know what? They both work awesome. And I wanted to use 1.75 because I had a couple items that were made for 1.75. And, you know, it hangs on here great. I mean, that bungee sling is ridiculously good. Because, I mean, it's fatiguing to hang an AK off yourself all day long. I mean, it's tiresome even for a big guy like me, but that thing just holds it perfectly.
Dude, we get a lot of, where you really see it is in long classes, like you're saying right now, old guys, like a lot of squirrel hunters are old dudes behind dogs for miles a day, just chasing squirrels and shit, and that's where they see it with the deer rifles and that bungee. Every step they take, it takes that shock out of their bodies, especially when they get a little bit older. And then as far as the 1.75, that's something new for you, right? The last few classes,
yep.
Last time we saw you, last couple belts we made in the videos, those were 1.5 belts.
Yep, EDCs.
So
yeah.
The 1.75, that was industry, like we've made a Rigger's belt in 1.75 for two decades. We've made the Cobra belt in 1.75 for about 10 years now. And that was the only size the Cobra buckle was available in because it came from the parachute hang glide industry. And they used it on risers and clip-in straps and stuff, and it was mil-spec life support webbing was 1.75. That's why there wasn't a 1.5 hardware. So when the 1.5 buckle came out, we started seeing some webbing trickle out. It's not life support webbing. It's a much stiffer dive belt webbing, the same as the 2-inch. But that was the industry standard. Like, there was no inch and a half stiff belt for, you know, 10 years ago. It didn't exist. And the 1.75 originally, that's the same webbing they used on 7A straps, which are the cargo straps that they used to tie pallets of equipment down in C-130 planes. And guys used to take those and they would just cut, it came as like a 36-inch strap, and they'd cut them down to about 6 feet or 5 feet, and that would become a belt. And then fast forward, the Rigger's belt, they'd have dudes in, you know, Rigger Paraloffs and stuff with that H315 adapter, which are the for the shoulder straps and stuff, the arm straps and the harness on a parachute. So fast forward to about 2003, and that's when the Cobra buckle came to be. Like, we can't get enough. Like, we just bought $50,000 in Cobra buckles. Like, you can't pay for that on a debit card. Like, we had to wire transfer that money over to them. It's nuts how many Cobra buckles we're going through. And still, with a 90-day speculation projection on our ordering, there's still times when we can't get enough. We'll order up 1,000 pieces of black 1.75, can't get them. Like, we're having to buy them still from middlemen. So it's nuts, man.
I mean, the SOE belts are awesome because it's tactical gear that you can use every single day, not just when you get to go out and train or get
right.
to go out and, I mean, like, I love my sling and rig, but I don't get to use it every single day.
Right.
So, I mean, the belts to me are essential, especially because whether you're carrying outside the waistband for class or most of the time inside the waistband, you need a good belt. And for me, I mean, I don't even take it off my pants.
Yeah,
I mean, I let them drop at the end of the day, and then I pull them right back up the next day.
Yeah, you use the same ones the next day. And we get kids, it's crazy the amount of people that come to the shop now. They've seen us on Facebook, they've seen us in the videos, and they come here, like, as a destination. I'm like, where'd you come from? Well, I drove, you know, 4 hours to get here. Why? Because you're here. So they come in just starry-eyed. A lot of, like, kids, moms, like, there's a kid here in class, mom brought him here. He's like, man, I've always wanted to meet you. This has been my dream, take attack response class. It's crazy. It's so humbling. And they come in, they're like, sell me something. What should I buy? And the reality of it is they all want that $550, $600 NSW chest rig. But even the dudes that own them, 90% of those dudes don't run those rigs, not to their, you know, capacity. But we can put them into a $50 belt or a $25 wallet or, you know, a visor cover, and you know, it's stuff they'll use every day. They'll put their pants on and clip that thing every day, and they're like, man, I got an SOE belt on.
Yeah.
And they're just stoked on it, and it's so cool. And the reality is you're more likely to use medical equipment to fix holes than you are to put holes in somebody, you know, auto accident, you know, chainsaw, lawnmower, you know, whatever it is, every day, just, you know, walking around, you see somebody have an accident almost every day somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
So
what's next for SOE? Anything big and exciting?
Man, we just I don't know. We just have fun. Like, I'm hiring people. I'm hiring, you know, dudes that I care about. I'm hiring people. Lance Manning, I met him, 17 years ago. One of my first customers from Marine Corps, 1st Battalion Reconnaissance. He works here full-time now. We just hired another TAC Response alumni guy, Tyler Wilson. Just literally moved here from Alaska to come work here. Colin Walls, we hired him. He was driving to work 90 minutes, 4 days a week. He just moved here to Paris and works here full-time now. Just staff, developing the staff, just infrastructure at this point. Like, we've got the product now, just figuring out how to make more of it faster and how to ship it. Every time we get better at one thing, we're weaker at another thing. So we get the capacity up to where we can build the stuff, then we got to figure out how to ship it faster. So that's when dealers come in, and how do you, you know, juggle and feeding dealers and individual orders. It's just, dude, it's constantly. When you strengthen up one part of the chain, another part weakens. So.